your favorite dog breed might actually vanish in your lifetime. So which ones are in danger and what's pushing them over the edge? To find out, we asked AI to analyze the data, spot the trends, and predict the breeds most likely to go extinct by 2050. Some of the results might surprise you, and trust me, you'll want to see the breed at the very end. According to AI, it has an 85% chance of disappearing entirely. But first, let's start with a tough little terrier you've probably never heard of, and that's exactly the problem. Number 8. The Glen of a Mall Terrier. Meet the Glen of a Mall Terrier, a scrappy Irish farm dog that's quietly becoming about as rare as a four-leaf clover. There's a good chance you've never even heard of this breed. I know I haven't, and honestly, that's part of their problem. This little-known Irish farm dog was bred to hunt vermin and keep a low profile. Seriously, one of their original jobs was turning a meat spit in the kitchen. Not exactly glamorous. Today, they're still low maintenance, loyal, and surprisingly chill for a terrier, but almost no one knows they exist. With fewer farms around and most families wanting something more Instagram ready, this little terrier is losing popularity fast. Right now, fewer than 300 Glen puppies are born worldwide each year, with around 30 or fewer in the UK. Every breeder who calls it quits shrinks their gene pool even further, pushing them closer to extinction. Unless these quiet terriers suddenly become social media stars or land a Hollywood role, hint hint Disney, their numbers will keep slipping. Sadly, without a popularity boost, the Glen of a Mall Terrier might quietly fade away, without most people ever knowing it existed in the first place. And if you think being forgotten is bad, this next breed had fame, royal fans, and a front row seat in history, only to end up on the edge of extinction anyway. Number 7. The Sealy Ham Terrier. Blink and you might miss this little white firecracker. The Sealy Ham Terrier, once the toast of British high society, now pops up about as often as a solar eclipse. Built in Wales for badger hunting, Sealy Hams are fearless, stocky, and frankly, look like walking cotton balls with eyebrows. But bravery and eyebrows don't pay the bills. The breed slipped off center stage when the hunting faded, and lapdog chick took over. So why the slide? First, grooming. That snowy coat needs regular hand stripping, not exactly a Saturday hobby for busy owners. Second, competition. Designer mixes steal the spotlight with hypoallergenic marketing. And finally, they have a small gene which leads to big problems. Having a limited bloodline means higher risk of hereditary eye and spine issues. Breed clubs run open stud books and even borrow genes from related terriers. But progress crawls at a slow pace. Now, while the Sealy Ham Terrier faded despite having everything going for it, our next one might disappear simply because it was born too weird for its own good. Number 6. The Norwegian Lundhund. This dog can bend like a yoga instructor and climb cliffs like a mountain goat. But even with all that talent, the Norwegian Lundhund is in serious trouble. These quirky pups were once used to hunt puffins on Norway's rocky coastline. Yes, you heard that right. And they were built for the job. Extra toes, crazy flexible joints, and an ability to fold their ears shut like little doggy trapdoors. Pretty cool, right? But puffin hunting is a thing of the past, and now, so are most Lundhunds. Currently, there are only about 1,500 of them left worldwide. What makes it scarier is that every single one of them is descended from just 6 dogs. That's not a gene pool, it's more like a gene puddle. So because of inbreeding, many suffer from serious digestive problems that require lifelong care. Between the health issues and the super specific needs, most people just pass by them. And breeders? They're fighting an uphill battle just to keep the breed stable. So unless something dramatic happens, this one's future is hanging by a thread. But if unusual anatomy made survival hard, the next breed faces a simpler problem. There's just not enough room left in the world for giants. Number 5. The Scottish Deerhound. There's a point in every deerhound owner's life when they realize they're basically living with a horse, a very polite, very sleepy horse. Scottish deerhounds are massive, gentle, and quiet, but their size is also their downfall. In a world of condos, city parks, and Uber pets, owning a lanky deer chaser just isn't practical anymore. Most people don't have the space, the time, or the appetite to feed a dog that looks like it could enter the Kentucky Derby. To make matters worse, their health isn't great either. These dogs don't live long, around 8 to 10 years, and their limited population makes breeding a serious challenge. For example, in 2023, only 132 were born in the UK. That's barely enough to fill the stands at a youth soccer match. Unlike their popular cousins, the Greyhound, Scottish Deerhounds never had a racing spotlight or rescue movement to boost their image. Instead, they've stayed in the background, quiet, noble, and increasingly rare. That said, the Scottish Deerhound could end up more of a legend than a living breed. And while that gentle giant is slipping into legend, the next breed is known for tracking legends down, until technology started beating them at their own game. Number 4. The Bloodhound. You'd think having the best nose in the animal kingdom would be enough to stay relevant, but not even a super sniffer can guarantee saving the Bloodhound from fading out. These dogs used to be heroes, and a few still are, tracking missing people, sniffing out fugitives, basically doing CSI work with a tail. But now, most of that's been replaced with drones, GPS, and high-tech sensors that don't drool all over your back seat. Plus, bloodhounds come with some baggage. For instance, that iconic wrinkly face needs constant cleaning, and their long ears are dirt magnets. Plus, let's just say they aren't the healthiest breed either. Currently, breeders are struggling, and the demand just isn't there anymore. It's not that people don't love them. They're gentle, loyal, and kind of hilarious when they start howling at the wind. But the world moved on, and the bloodhound didn't. So unless they somehow make it back to mainstream, this breed could be sniffing its way into extinction. While the bloodhound may be losing its job, the next breed is losing something even harder to get back: relevance. Number 3. The Sussex. The Sussex Spaniel has one speed: slow. And unfortunately, their drop in numbers isn't slow either. These golden brown fluff balls were originally bred to move slowly through dense brush while hunting. That was their canine superpower. But today, their laid-back vibe and low energy don't exactly scream must-have to most modern dog owners. They're also pretty vocal for a chill breed. In fact, Sussex Spaniels are known to be loud, opinionated, and not shy about sharing their thoughts with the neighbors. Combine that with short legs, stubborn streaks, and high grooming needs, and you've got a breed that's, well, a bit of a tough sell. Registrations have been low for years, and their gene pool is getting worryingly tight. The breed isn't dying out because it's broken. It just doesn't fit into the world most people live in now. Sure, there are still a few diehard fans keeping the Sussex Spaniel's 200-year-old legacy alive, but it's not sustainable forever. And if a breed like the Sussex can fade without ever being famous, what happens when one had it all and still vanished from view? Number 2. The Skye Terrier. This dog once had royal fans, marble statues, and even a spot in Queen Victoria's heart. But unfortunately, the Skye Terrier is barely hanging on today. They're long, low, and honestly kind of funny looking. Imagine a mop with attitude. But beneath their floor-length coat is a bold, loyal terrier with a big personality. So how did a royal favorite fall this far off the radar? Well, for starters, most people don't want to deal with the grooming, the stubbornness, or the fact that strangers constantly ask, "Is that a dog or a walking wig?" In 2023, fewer than 40 Skye Terrier puppies were born in the UK, and that's after a brief rebound. Before that, the numbers were even worse. These dogs aren't sickly or broken. They're just not trendy. No TV show, no marketing push, and not even a modern job has kept them in the spotlight. And while breed clubs are doing everything they can, the math is brutal. Without consistent demand, breeding programs collapse fast. One or two retirements, and entire bloodlines disappear. But if fading from fame is harsh, the next breed is on the edge of true extinction. When numbers get this low, it's not just rare, it's nearly unrecoverable. Number 1. The Otterhound. There are rare dogs, And then there's the otter hound. Most people have never seen one in real life, and pretty soon, they might not ever at all. Right now, there are fewer than 800 otter hounds left in the entire world. Not in the UK, not in Europe, the whole world. That includes active pets, retirees, and the handful still being bred. You could fit the entire population into a movie theater and still have room for popcorn. So what happened? These dogs were originally bred to hunt otters in rivers, but when that was banned decades ago, their job disappeared. And without a job, the breed quietly slipped off the radar. Add in their massive size, muddy paws, and a thick, oily coat that smells like river funk even when clean, and you can see why modern dog owners haven't exactly rushed to adopt them. Breeders and enthusiasts are working hard to keep the otter hound alive, but with such a tiny gene pool, even one bad year could be devastating. It's literally a slow-motion extinction happening before our eyes. Unless there's a major rescue effort or sudden demand, we may be looking at the last generation of otter hounds. Hey, if you enjoyed this, you'll probably love this video here. And if you hit subscribe, I'll donate a meal to a rescue dog on your behalf.